We'd exhausted every avenue before this coup. They left us no choice.
It is a David and Goliath battle.
She had warned the police that morning that there could be violence.
I just thought someone was gonna get punched on the face.
If the cops ever question me, I'm gonna pin it on Sam.
I am disgruntled, but that's not the reason why I did what I did.
What's the word I'm looking for?
Chaotic.
Just noisy.
Nobody could hear anything.
Revolutionary.
Not Christian.
Give me a word, man.
Frustration.
Yeah, that's a good word. We'll go with that. You're probably trying to get change quicker than the organisation wanted to do it.
Supposed to be one, but that day it got divided.
Our Heavenly Father, we commit this day to your care and keeping. Have mercy on our city, mercy on our nation, mercy on those who have done terrible things for which they know not what they do.
So Fred Nile has definitely been the figurehead of the Christian Democratic Party for a long time now. He's been very much known as the moral crusader in New South Wales. His key issues have kind of been around homosexuality.
God made male and female, Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve.
Abortion.
We can hear the cry of that baby in the womb.
He's very strong on banning the wearing of the burqa.
There will be no more Muslims coming to Australia. The priority will be persecuted Christians.
Regardless of what people might feel about his politics and his policies, he is a very respected legislator. Like, he is known in the upper house as being very good at being able to work with all the parties. He's got the title of the grandfather of the house because he is definitely the oldest member of the house at 84.
Many people think it's out of respect, but there's lots of bad connotations with it, such as the fact that he does frequently take nap times in the chamber.
The opposition often throw kind of comments at him about, you know, napping in the chamber.
No, I'm not napping. No, I'm usually pretty alert in the parliament.
Immediately after they had the state council meeting on the Saturday, members of the Christian Democratic Party started emailing, and clearly I knew pretty early on that obviously something quite interesting had gone on.
If you choose to stop what's happening here, it will be over. May no longer be a Christian Democrat party for the next
election. Owner of the venue, okay, you all have to leave. Because this is his building.
Hi, my name's Joel. I'm 22. I'm a friend of Samrat's. And together we pulled off the biggest political coup since Julie Gillard's 2013 leadership spill.
Josh, this is not your place.
The old order did not recognise it had to change.
Fred had succession issues, and when I approached the leaders about these issues, I was frequently shut down.
The tension's just been building, and we had to make a move. We didn't have a choice. The party was going downhill.
Things like poor management, the lack of democracy, you know, members' voices weren't necessarily heard.
What more could you do? Either inaction or action. We chose action.
Do you want to help me to feed the chickens a bit?
In a suit?
Yeah. Come on.
They crap everywhere.
Don't worry.
My name is Samrat Joshua Grewal. I'm 18 years old and I'm the president of the Christian Democratic Party's Youth Wing. I was born in Blacktown. I lived in New Zealand for a couple of years and I came back a few years ago and I've lived in Mount Druitt ever since. Is that all?
Yeah, they've laid one egg today.
I go to Hillsong Church, but I'm not what people typically call a happy clapper. I don't necessarily like the music there, I'm more into the teachings they have. So I forgot to add some attachments to it. So I have to send it back to them. So I've got a variety of hobbies, from art and music to video games, like every other 18-year-old in the state. And I do, you know, appreciate good historical books and political literature as well. Here we have Karl Marx's Communist Manifesto and Adolf Hitler's Mein Kampf. When I was about 16 years old, I was looking to get into politics, and that's when I found the Christian Democratic Party and signed up as a volunteer and eventually became a member of the party.
We employed Josh as an administrative assistant, and he was our receptionist, and he was very good on Microsoft Office applications.
Saturday during the first was a state council meeting. It's a monthly meeting of members to vote on different issues and hear reports on the board.
We had our usual group prayer, and as soon as that prayer finished, I moved a motion to dissolve the current New South Wales CDP board. I put the motion forward, and it was shut down by the chair.
One of them even got up to Samrat's face. I actually thought Samrat was gonna get punched on the face, you know, because he's just telling Samrat, go and sit down. And I just thought, going to a nice meeting, just hear both sides out.
It's a Christian meeting in progress. You respect the president. You need to respect the agenda.
So after we moved the motion of dissent and had it seconded, he ruled out of order. Then I debated with him and I pulled out the laws and I said, this act and that act and this regulation says this and that. And he just got fed up and said, meeting's adjourned, and walked out.
If you were at the meeting, you would have realised why we had to adjourn it. Because nobody could hear anything.
When you see a board walk out like they just did, not even to discuss, not even to listen to the youth of the party.
I'm entitled to adjourn a meeting when the meeting has just become totally unruly.
Checkmate.
Well, the board is still in place, and there is another group, the interim committee, and Josh is running that, as I understand it. But they're two separate entities, and the board is still in place at the moment.
It will be significant in the party's history if Joel and Joshua actually pull it off. So basically, if the legal advice comes back that the motion they move to overthrow the board, which means Fred Nile's gone as, you know, a senior person in the party, Ross Clifford's gone, you know, that board is gone, then it will be hugely significant because it will be a complete changing of the guard.
Do you think the Christian Democrats are in trouble, or is everything under control?
Everything's under control. We're a very well-organised political party and a very loyal membership. Joshua made a fool of himself, he's only 18. I think they were short-circuiting the system. They just need to be a bit more patient.
People have reacted quite in a shocked manner, especially since that it resembles that of a coup. But it's quite unusual because it's done by an 18-year-old and a 22-year-old at the forefront.
He was just too young. And it's not me saying that, that's all the other party members saying that, who are in their 30s and 40s, married with children and so on, saying, well, we can't have an 18-year-old telling us how to run the party.
I'd like to think that the people in time, in the history books, when it's written, maybe even Wikipedia, would believe that this was a move to reform the party, bring it into the 21st century. We may be losing the battle, but we will win the war.
Do you see yourself as a Judas character within this story?
No, I don't see myself as a Judas character, but I do see myself in that capacity as someone who's been raised up to fix issues in the party, like the judges were meant to fix issues in Israel 2,000 years ago.
Hey there, my name is Mark Fennell, and if you enjoyed that, and I'm hoping that you did, then make sure you like and subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel, and definitely watch that thing that I have absolutely seen before. It's really good.